Welcome, gang. My name is Kyle with the Super7 Design Team, and I am here today to talk to you about the
Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Ultimates Wave 5.
Pre-order.
And here's Ray Fillet, with all the stuff he comes with. Ray Fillet might be my favorite from this wave. You'll probably hear me say that a lot. Ray Fillet, just like our other Ultimates figures, is based off of his vintage figure. So you'll recognize some of those key design traits, like his textured wetsuit, the V on his chest, his flippers here, his very impressive wings. This is a resin paint master, so he's really heavy and they're not quite attached, but just look how cool that looks.
Whoa!
There'll be a swivel here at the tail. The rest of him is fully articulated, so he'll have a ball joint here at the head so he can move and you can swap out the heads. Look how cool that looks. He'll have elbow joints, knee joints, shoulder and hip joints, and ankle rocker and wrist joints, and a little ball joint at the waist. So this guy will be able to move like no other once he's not a resin paint master and he's in your collection. Next up, we got Krang, everyone's favorite being from another dimension. He comes with so much stuff, like the vintage figure times 10,000, right? First thing you'll probably notice is the alternate Krang look, and this is because typically we give you the alternate head situation for Ultimate figures, but with Krang, his whole body is his head. So instead of giving you an alternate head for Krang, we're giving you an alternate Krang. This one, little angrier, a little more enthusiastic. The arms will also be able to switch out, so you can choose how to display your Ultimate Krangs. You know, there's these arms here, which are doing the wave, right? And then there's these ones, which are flexing on fools. I personally like this screaming one with one arm doing this and one arm doing this, so you can tell people to
get off of his lawn.
The other head sculpt is, you know, nice little smile, good reference to that vintage figure. He will also come with a bunch of hands too. So he's gonna come with two gripping hands, two open grabby hands, two trigger finger hands for shooting his plunger gun, one fist and one pointing hand for the arms. The arms of the walker will be removable, so you can display your walker however you want. Coolest part of this walker though, to me, is this big old dome that's clear. This is a resin paint master, so it's not gonna be able to function as much as I want it to right now, but you'll be able to see that in the final figure, this will be able to swivel open and you can take your Krang out and switch it around with your other Krangs. There, the inside is fully sculpted as well. And it's very easy to choose your display options for Krang. Krang will also come with his plunger gun lastly. The tube here will be rubberized. This again, this is the resin paint master. This is hard and brittle, but it'll be able to plug in here or here into the body. And he'll be able to grip it and shoot it at the turtles. Let's take a second to get into the articulation here on Krang. It may look like a very simple walker, but we decided to try and take this walker to the next level for Krang, since these arms aren't gonna be able to do much, but this walker should be able to do some cool stuff. So like I said, the dome will be able to swivel up and down and come up and come down. The legs are actually on ball joints at the hip here. You can see that. So they'll be able to go out and in and all around a little bit. There'll be a nice knee swivel here. And believe it or not, there's actually an ankle rocker here at these robot feet. So you'll be able to get some really cool dynamic poses with this walker. Like I said also earlier, the arms are removable, so you can display it however you want. There will be a ball joint at the shoulder for these arms. And there's also gonna be wrist movement like this. And if you can see here, there's actually kind of a little swivel here at what I call the elbow, so he can kind of aim in and out with his gun and shoot it all around. So it may look like a very simple design, but it's actually very, very complex, and you'll be able to get some really cool poses out of your Krang. Now we have everyone's favorite Cajun,
Leatherhead.
This big old alligator is just ridiculous. One of my favorite turtle figures, and no exception for the Ultimates line, he comes with a ton of stuff. So let's get started and dive right into it here. He comes with a fully loaded weapons rack. For those of you who had that vintage figure of Leatherhead, you might recognize that he didn't come with a weapons rack, but we gave him one. in the form of a fly fishing rod. So the rod collapses and becomes the weapon rack. You'll also get a fully painted one as well, but you get this awesome weapons rack with all the stuff he comes with. On that weapons rack, you, like I said, you get the fly fishing rod, which is collapsible and really nice. Another cool addition to the Leatherhead arsenal. There's also a functioning bear trap, which is cool. You won't be able to trap anything significant with this, but it's cool that you got the jaws here. He'll also come with his shotgun. This one's a resin paint master, like I keep saying, but the actual shotgun will be able to, you know, reload and all that, and scare off people from the property. He'll come with all of the ingredients for his jumbo gumbo belt. So this turtle, a crawfish, and some sugar cane. He'll also come with some additional hands, as always. He'll come with two fists, two gripping hands, and two trigger finger hands for his shotgun. In addition to all of that, you get this really, really rad figure. So for Leatherhead here, he's a very strange figure, so we added some really cool articulation, and he posed a unique design challenge in what would need to be done for him to be able to move like we want him to. But I think you'll be very pleased with the results. This guy's a little bit fragile because he's a resin paint master, so bear with me here. He will have a ball joint at the tail, a ball joint at the abs, and some ball joint thighs here, as well as a nice knee swivel and some ankle pivot. There'll be a ball joint at the shoulders, an elbow swivel, you know, hands with interchangeable pegs and hands. And he'll also have a nice ball joint here at the neck as well, so he can look all around. And then this jaw will swivel, and he'll be able to snap and bite on some turtles. So we took that classic kind of vintage TMNT figure, the Leatherhead that everyone knows and loves, and just brought him into the modern age. And I think he turned out
extra rad.
And last but not least, we have Sewer Samurai Leo, the one turtle of the wave, the raddest and baddest guy in this whole wave, in my opinion. He comes with so much stuff, I don't even know where to start, so I'm going to try and just take it all in stride here with you. Just like every other ultimate figure we make, he comes with a fully loaded weapons rack.
Ooh.
With some swords, some kunai, some shuriken, and some cool claw accessories here. He'll come with his wacky war banner. Wacky war banner's on the way. Where the soft goods for this is in the shop right now. But trust me, it's going to look super cool. The best part about this thing is that he'll be able to store it on his back. There's a little belt loop right here, so you can carry your war banner into battle,
which is super, super fun.
He'll also come with a sheath for his swords. There'll be a string here. Again, soft goods, work in progress, that you'll be able to sling around his back and have him battle ready at any time. He comes with a bunch of hands, like a bunch of hands. He comes with two pairs of fists, four pairs of gripping hands, vertical and horizontal hinges, some martial arts hands, and some expressive hands too. So he just, again, fully loaded with this guy. He comes with some pizza, with some gross anchovies and fish heads on there, because turtles have really weird taste in pizza. He's got his fully painted shield. For those of you who had the vintage figure, you might remember that this was a not painted accessory in that original toy line. But now we give you a fully painted battle-ready shield with some nice golds and greens and reds and blues on here. There's even a nice dry brush to kind of bring out some of that script and sculpt detail. He's Leonardo, so he's going to come with a bunch of swords. As you can see here, he's got a bunch of swords, and he's even got a short sword like a Tonto. Coolest part about the swords for me is that in addition to the sheath, he's got kind of these belt loops here so he can store his swords. I can't show you with the resin swords that are here, but I do happen to have a plastic sword laying around from our first Leonardo release, and I can show you with confidence that he'll be able to hold the swords no problem, and it looks super fun. The last but not least accessory is the Samurai Mask Head. This is an alternate head, and it's got this awesome full samurai mask on Leo's face on top of the helmet. This is, again, a work in progress paint master, so the mask will actually be black with the gold teeth, but it's gonna look so, so cool. A new awesome way to display your Samurai Leo figure that you didn't have before. get into the articulation here on Samurai Leo. This is a resin paint master, so he's not going to be able to really move, but I can tell you that if you are familiar with our Ultimate Turtle figures, you will be very familiar with how this guy's going to be able to move and pose for your display. So he'll have, you know, head ball joint, the shoulder ball joint, a bicep swivel, some elbow joint, rotation, wrist joints with interchangeable hands, the, you know, ab crunch on the inside of the turtle shell, which is pretty cool. Some ball joint here at the thigh, knee swivel, and some full-on ankle pivot. So this guy will be able to do all kinds of cool samurai moves for your display. I just also want to take a minute to kind of admire the paint on this guy. This might be the best painted turtle that we've ever done so far. I mean, there's, you know, silver on the rivets of the helmet, and there's a different nice metallic green here on his shell. It's even got some metallic reds here on the armor, and this nice gold and blue has a really nice contrast to it too. It really takes this guy to the next level. So we're really, really excited about this guy, and I think you will be too. Get those pre-orders in, go to super7.com and check them out today.